done through all this thing is done through basically a supply chain model that I would like to discuss. So basically, first of all, I would like to tell you about significant shortcomings that are currently present. In India, there are no proper cold storage facilities, transportation facilities with the farmers, proper knowledge, and the basically milk. Most of the milk comes from the unorganized sector, from the farmers. They have domesticated towards with cattle from their house, and they are supplying milk from them. Basically, unsanitization is also causing a lot of degradation in milk quality. So, as you can see now, basically the model, which is the re-engineering process, goes in here. There's a three-step model, basically the procurement process, which is modified, and processing of the milk and distribution. I would like to show a chart to further explain this concept. Now, basically the most of the re-engineering went into this. As the most of the sector is domesticated and unorganized, we are trying to get two or three villages into a group of particular villages as categorized by regional areas. And then we're providing a common managed shed to particular village where the cattle will be taken on lease from the farmers, and the cattle will be transferred to the managed shed where they will get proper treatment, proper medical facilities, and the hygienic milk procurement settings. And with proper transportation, the milk will be transferred to the chilling center where it will be chilled and further transferred to the processing sector. So here we are trying to get the economics of the scale in processing and driving our costs down. Moreover, if you I like to talk about indirect taxation also. Now we are in the GST regime. As you all know, if in GST regime, we have a harmonized taxes all over the country. So when we are transferring milk from one state to another, we have just to pay one tax, and it will drive our cost further downwards and increase our profits, as there is no cascading effects on interstate transaction and interstate supplies. So we can have a common processing point for multiple states. Now, another thing which is went into re-engineering, I would like to show. As you can see, the cattle are basically prone to thermal and humidity stress. So we have to manage a cool temperature and with low humidity for maintaining this. And this is more crucial for basically foreign breeds, and to get foreign breeds and more high quality milk, I have proposed an idea to manage the temperature is water running through a beehive mud system. As you have all, you can also see the system in Air One, I guess. There is a company, Air One, which is providing system like this. So this system is incorporated in the walls of the shed, and the walls of the shed will also provided with silica gel tubes, which will absorb the excess humidity, and for drying the silica gel tube, biogas produced from the cow dung will be used. Now, basically it is for maintaining sanitary is automatic milking system and on-site medication and testing for the cattle for better health. Now, there is another major problem in India. So raw material is crucial for every industry, and fodder is the raw material for the basically for producing milk. So even with significant update in technology and growing number of dairy farms, fodder problem remains a constant major shortcoming in India. To battle this problem, I can propose a system like this. This is hydroponic system of multi-layering fodder system, which farmers can be provided with.
Timing is up. 5 minutes are over.
Can I get a 1 minute to move? So this is a financial snapshot provided regarding the system and major.
We'll try to wrap up in 20 seconds.
Okay, ma'am. So major weakness and threat will be the farmers, domesticated the farmers. They like sentiments involved in this. So they might be not ready to revolutionize it. There's already companies involved in delivering milk through online system like Country Delight and Amul. So we can provide we can convert the milk into milk powder and whey protein powder and export it to the countries, so driving more revenues and more revenues eventually for the farmers. So I would like to wrap it up. Thank you, everyone. This is it.
Thank you, Anmol. I would request if our expert has any questions regarding his presentation.
Anmol, the idea is what you'll be having cows. You'll be managing the fodders. You'll be managing the milk supply chain also. Everything. So you'll be owning cows?
No, sir. We are not owning the cows. We are taking it on lease basis from the farmers.
Lease basis on the farmer, that means what?
Like, sir,
like machinery, you cannot take. Hmm?
like currently farmers are procuring the milk themselves from the cows and they are selling
cows,
it to the
cows are not the machinery or say equipments which you can take on lease and then use it. You can you can guarantee the supply of milk from the cows.
That's the change, sir. Actually, currently farmers are procuring the milk themselves from the cows, and they are supplying to the chilling centers or the local centers in their villages.
No, that part was clear, right?
So they have not proper transportation facilities. So we are doing is like a cow produces 10 liters of milk per day with the farmers, with their unsanitary procedures, and they don't have proper knowledge of the nutrition to the cow. So we are basically taking cow from the farmer to a particular shed, and we are providing proper facilities to the cattle. And jitna bhi wo milk produce kar rahi hai, we are providing a commission based system to the farm.
That part is understood. My question is that you'd be managing the cows also.
Yes, right? Sir.
I think that part is a very difficult part of your supply chain, right? And yeah. Then you are putting your hands everywhere. Right. Instead of this one, my suggestion that you have a contract with the cow owners. You train them how to feed them, how to keep them proper, right? And then the leasing part in the financial you have not shown, right? If you look at your financial revenue is only through the sale of the milk, and cost does not include anything like say taking care of the cow.
So
you have the financial with you. I mean, right now, but
taking care of cow, I have taken the fodder, cost of the fodder of the cow and miscellaneous expenses. That includes it.
You have taken fodder, commission to farmer, workman salary, fixed cost.
Fixed cost and recovery
miscellaneous expenses, yes. So miscellaneous expenses as a part of your revenue, if you look at the percentage of revenue is very small compared to what we have managing the cow. And in the first year itself, we have profit. So don't you think this amount of profit, what is the percentage of profit you are having in year one? Net profit ratio?
That's more than 20%.
More than?
20%.
So do you think if a business has 20% profit, so it'll not attract the other, kind of businessmen, the capital?
That will attract other businessmen also, but we are first mover in this category.
Okay, right. So my suggestion that you need to make it more realistic, the figures of financials, right? And also try to include in your business plan the existing model, right? None of the pages of your plan have studied what is the existing model of the business, right? Because there are several new startups in this particular dairy area. Right, especially to the society nearby Delhi NCR. So you need to look at their models and look at the problems in the model, and then from that gap, build your model. Right. Right now, my opinion says that the model is too much optimistic. Right. One, and second, your financials. And second, do not engage everything now from cow to taking care of cow to bringing them to the shed, then medication, then fodder, and then taking milk. So if you empower the farmers, right, make them as a part of your business model, right? So they'll also grow with you. They'll be happy. So train them and get them milk. And then only a supply chain of milk would be a good business plan. Right.
So basically, in this model, I have tried. Can I pick?
Say again.
So basically, in this model, basically the core of the project is to engage the farmers.
No, it is not. It is everything you want to do it.
No. We are taking the cows from the farmers to a common shed. We are giving a percentage, common percentage amount per liter of milk to the farmer.
Possibly, if you take farmer, cow from the farmer, yeah, and manage them. So there is nothing, no attachment with the cow, no?
Yeah, basically, that's the
core point. From a businessman, if you take business, will they feel okay?
What, sir?
From a businessman, if you take a business, will they feel okay?
So they are
the same as from the farmers, if you take out the cow, so they'll not be, feel attached to the business, your business model. So empower them, my suggestion, empower them, get what you like. You need only milk, right?
Yes, sir.
You need milk and you want them to be continuously supplied to you. So focus on it. है ना. So because the business nowadays they are focusing on their core area. So your core area is the supply chain of the supply chain of the milk. So how you get it and how you supply to the end user.
Yeah.
So focus on this part. The earlier part, leave it to the farmers. Empower them, right? So that you get the continuous supply of milk, because they'll add up to your cost also, and burden also. So you have operational issues also. Managing cow is not so easy, no, sitting in room.
Yeah, that's
then also problem. Additionally, apart from these things, you need to also look at the incentive of Government of India. They have so much of schemes. You can get almost 50% subsidy in the price of the cow and so on.
Well, tell them to the development banks also provide a very subsidized rate loans to the farmers.
Right. Right. Okay. All the best. Look at the financials also. Make it more realistic. Right.
Okay, and thank you so much.
Compare, my suggestion is that because see, in UG you are doing this, is very good job that you have this idea in your mind. My suggestion that you should also look at the existing, you know, the suppliers of the milk in the nearby area, right? Yeah, especially Delhi and NCR. There are at least 15 you'll find. Apart from the big brand like Amul and Mother Dairy, there are many brands.
Yes, sir. Right?
So I was living in Ibrahimpuram. I think there are at least 3 to 4 new brands which have came up, and all of them were, you know, publishing that they'll supply milk to the home every day, and there was many offers. So look at their supply chain. Fine, right? So all the best.
Thank you so much, sir.
Maybe someone else would like to add.
Let us take all the presentations first, and then we will take the audience queries if the time permits.
Right, fine, yes.
Okay, all right. Or no, you can continue.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Anmol. Next up is Bhoomika Rastogi. Bhoomika, are you there?
Am I audible now?
Yeah, you're audible.
Okay. So, good morning, all of you. My name is Bhoomika Rastogi, and my startup's name is Era. Now, to give insight into what actually inspired me to nurture this idea, I would like to share a story with all of you. Last year, my friend and I had a CAT exam. Our slot was 8:30 to 10:30 in the morning. So I called her to wish good luck at around 7:30, I guess, in the morning, and casually asked, have you kept your admit card and declaration form? And she literally forgot to print the declaration form, and without the declaration form, the applicants weren't even allowed to step a foot in the facilities. So she was in a state of panic, and luckily her we would need to be there 20 minutes prior before the exam. So we had 40 minutes to arrange the photocopy, but she didn't know any shop. And lucky enough, my father knows the photocopy shop owner, and he personally requested the owner to open the shop and get the document printed for her. But what if we didn't know the shopkeeper? Then the year would be wasted, because without the declaration form, we weren't allowed. So if my app existed back then, she would have an advantage. She could easily put her location in the app, and the shop within that radius could deliver the form to her. The problem would be solved. Era not only provides users information about respective shops in a particular area, but also provides the service of delivery. SWOT analysis, strength. My business model is asset. By asset-less, I mean that it is we do not need machineries or equipment, but basic computers, printers, etc., like a normal office space. Second, it will help in increasing employment opportunities. We are directly or indirectly employing the delivery person, and of course, the shops which are in the remote areas, have an advantage to have an advantage to engage with us, and through with the application they would have the more customer base, and it will help in increasing the employment opportunities. Simple and friendly user interface. In today's time, an application should have a user friendly interface, because if an application has a very standard way, then it discourages the customer to use the application. It is less expensive and help in time management. Of course, it is less expensive and helps in time management, because earlier you would need to be in the long queue and wait for 5 to 10 minutes to get the document printed. But through the application, you just need to send the app. You just need to send a respective document to the shop you have chosen in the respective area, and you have the option to get it yourself or get the document to your doorstep. This business model will help those shops which are situated in remote areas. This will give their business a hope, of course. Environment friendly model. Our business wouldn't be contributing to pollutions like air, water, like normal businesses do, factory waste, sewage, etc. This practice will replace traditional method to modern method. We are turning the traditional approach to an online platform. It will help the people in time management, and by replacing it, it will also increase the employment opportunities. Weakness. As it is in its very initial stage, the application will need time to make its hold in the market. It is a very basic, first weakness any business faces, whether online or offline. Competition from search engines like Google. There is competition from search engines like Google, of course, and you would be thinking, like, if I am facing the competition from Google, then how would my application thrive in the business? How would I make profit? So applications like Zomato and Swiggy existed, and long before they started making profits, they incurred heavy losses because of the competition from search engines like Google. But in the application, they provide a standardized way of the information, and they are specifically made for the food ordering, and they provide other services like delivery and etc. So we would also be providing the delivery option, other services to the users and the service provider. It's difficult to access capital as a new business, and equally difficult to predict just how much you will need. As a new business, my budget is very unpredictable. Opportunity, rapid technology development. So this is a time where technology is developing very fast. So if we tap on that resource, it will be beneficial for us. As Atmanirbhar Bharat mission is in full force, we will easily get loans from the banks to set up, grow. And
Bhumika, the time is over.
Okay, just give me a minute, ma'am.
Bhumika, just wrap up in another 20 seconds.
Yes, I can.
Okay.
Business model can be easily imitated by other players, and the market is very volatile. You cannot predict anything about the market, and the data security breaches are like happening every day. Commercial viability, we will be charging 5% commission on every assignment, and for the initial months it will give the service provider an edge, and then by when they start making profits, we will charge an increased amount of percentage on every assignment. We will advertise other applications on our platform. It will also provide revenue and additional revenue from the shops who want to be first in the search list, and of course the consultancy services. Cost structure, the tentative budget is 25 to 30 lakhs, and this includes development of the application, setup cost of hiring, miscellaneous expenses. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you, Bhumika. If sir has a question to ask.
Yes, Bhumika, it's good that the problem which you have taken up is, you know, which most of the students face, right?
Yes,
getting
sir.
Photocopy and all these things, right? But I have a serious issue with the model which you are selecting. That is already there on your slides. For example, threat, right? The slides of threat. Why somebody, you know, would send on the app his or her, you know, the admit card or any document to somebody who is unknown? So there is a serious privacy issue, right? And yes, secondly, sir, if you look at your cost structure, how much does it cost to get a photocopy or to get a printout? Say 5 rupees?
Yeah,
right? College area is hardly 2 rupees. So do you think your business model will survive?
Yes, sir, it definitely will, because in the...
And in one of the slides, you are saying it will be environment friendly. But exactly, it is not environment friendly, because maybe sometime, I don't know, in some year it will come that we don't need admit card, right? So maybe some digital device would get our signature, would get our image, or maybe thumb impression that will mark our attendance. So will your business sustain in those cases?
I think yes, because we always need documents in a specified way. My father, who is also a businessman, he needs his documents in a file. A phone cannot be trusted because kabhi kho jata hai and like toot jata hai, to wo cheez ek uncertainty hoti hai wahan par. So jo bhi jitne bhi millennials and like our generation, they need it in a standardized way. कि कभी कुछ भी ब्रीच होता है या एनीथिंग एक्सेट्रा, सो दे नीड, दे हैव द बैकअप ऑफ दैट. सो पेपर कभी भी टच से जाएगा नहीं, फैशन से जाएगा नहीं, एंड जो बैकअप एंड सिक्योरिटी द डॉक्यूमेंट द प्रिंटेड डॉक्यूमेंट्स प्रोवाइड, वो एक अलग लेवल होता है सेटिस्फेक्शन का.
आर यू अवेयर ऑफ सम ऐप कॉल्ड एज डिजी लॉकर? डिजी लॉकर,
yes sir.
The app by the government of India, where all the certificates of class 10, 12 and all graduation would be put in the locker, and you can download anywhere, and it is safe compared to the app which would be built by third party. Every time you'll have a question on the privacy issue, somebody would not like to give their because most of the admit card has phone number, email ID, the address of the home. So maybe people would be hesitant to give the detail to someone, the shops which are not, which are not known to them, right? So this is one of the issue. Maybe you can think of this one. And secondly, the issue of the cost practically is not feasible, because if you get it for 5 rupees, now you said ki you send it to some app based photocopier shop, and that shop owner would get it, print out and bring it to the address, home address. And there is no delivery charge and anything, you have mentioned this one, right? So maybe you can look at the cost structure, right? Charging 5 rupees and getting all this return is slightly difficult. Fine, so find out from people who can do plus minus, would question something positive about it, something negative about it. And there is no threat from Google. Google is not in the service like this one. And we need to go and check. There are many kind of technology which has been obsolete, right? So make any plan which is future proof, right? So find out where are the problem area and then work out on those areas.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
So all the best, right? Next one.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Homika. The next one is Danish Zisha. Danish, are you there? Danish, are you there?
Yes, Danish is there.
Can you please present your screen and... Ma'am Monica, should I move on then? Because he's not responding.
Yeah, you can take the next one.
Okay, ma'am. So after Danish, it's Deeksha Porwal.
Deeksha is not present.
Okay, so Deeksha is not there. So the next one is Isha Gurnani. Isha, are you there?
Yeah, can I share my screen?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Is it visible?
No, not yet.
Okay.
Screen is not shared, Isha.
Yeah, ma'am. I'm just trying. Is it visible right now?
Yeah, it's visible.
Okay. Greetings, everyone. I hope that you all are safe and doing great. My name is Isha Gunani, and my business plan, which I have named as Healthy Brains, is going to be a not-for-profit business case. Usually, every other entrepreneur desires to grow the working capital, but I'll be working on improving the human capital. Before moving ahead, I would like to give you all a glimpse of what Healthy Brains is all about. Well, in today's working world, where every other human being, whether employee or boss, no matter what's the job status, is actually suffering from mental pressures like competitions, target achievements, but this is where Healthy Brains comes into play. Healthy Brains comes to contribute and build a better working world by introducing business therapists where just business consultants exist. People will be able to confront their problems and conquer their dreams. Now, you all might be wondering what are going to be the objectives and impact of Healthy Brains, or what it is going to be for. Well, the objectives are as follows. We will be providing business therapists where just business consultants exist. We will be focusing on providing specialized solutions through mentors and focusing on developing a stress-free workforce and help people grow mentally and professionally. Now, let us move on to the impacts which will be given by Healthy Brains. People will be able to find healthy solutions provided by the experts. There will be regular counselings and meetings to help people continuously improve. They will be able to confront their mental issues and deal with them. And at the end of the day, we will be able to achieve a stress-free workforce with healthy brains, which will be able to contribute much more in the organization and in the environment. Now, let us move on to see what are the other, or who are the other not-for-profits operating in this space. That is basically our competitors. Well, there are many, but here I would like to discuss some of them. Number one is National Alliance for Mental Illness. Then we have Rad Remedy, This Is My Brave, Brain and Behavior Research Foundation, the Minds Foundation, and the Banyan. But you know what's the problem is? They just focus on dealing with the mental issues. They never have focused on dealing with the mental issues that are being faced by people who work in the corporate sector. Now, let us move on and see what will be the innovations that I will be providing through Healthy Brains, because innovation is something that can be the key thing to deal with the competition. So basically, first of all, we will be providing the business therapist, which is business consultant sectors. We will be dealing with work-related mental problems with much more appropriation and specification. These problems will be discussed much more openly and with less hesitation. People will be able to confront their problems and deal with them with practical solutions. And at the end of the day, it's all going to improve the workforce performance. Now, let us move on to what will be the high-level implementation plan for the first year. We will be focusing on three things. PPT, that is people, process, and technology needed. So basically, in the people thing, we will be initially hiring the staff members, you can say the HR team. When it is established, we will be focusing on hiring the mentors from various professional backgrounds, which will be providing various solutions to people. Secondly, as being it is a not-for-profit organization, we will be doing each and everything with as abided by the laws. And when it comes to the technology needed, our star point, you can say, is going to be the AI application app, which will be assisted by a language feature, multiple language feature, so that people may not get any language barrier while telling their problems to the mentors. Now, let us move ahead to what is the investment that will be needing in the first year. Basically, it is actually a not-for-profit organization, so we will be dealing our business on the basis of contributions and donations. But apart from them, the investments that are required, they are as follows. These are the basic investments, that is the office space, mobile application, which requires heavy investment initially, and the brochures, advertisement for promotion, and then the workforce and office staff. Now, being a commerce student and also a chartered accountancy student, I have always learned to keep profits in my pocket so that I can expand in the further years. So let us see what will be the total operating cost. In the first and second year, the collective outcomes are as follows. The mentors will be around 200 at least from various professional backgrounds to provide various solutions. Then the client number is expected to be around 500, because many people have been suffering from these kind of professional issues. And when it comes to contributions and donations, we will have 8 lakh to 12 lakh rupees in the initial initial years, which we'll be approaching to the government, be as it is an NGO, so we'll be approaching for the donations. And last but not the least, the operating costs. Initially, they will be high, around 10 lakhs. But as we all know that in the initial years, it takes cost to establish the business. And from the second year, it is expected to be 5 lakhs.
5 minutes are over.
Yeah, ma'am. I just wrap up. In further years, we will be able to decrease it and increase the profit margin. At the end, I would like to conclude that being a not-for-profit organization, it focuses on building the human capital, because to improve a nation or to improve any economy, the human capital has to be improved. And teachers like you are esteemed guests, and students like you all can be mentors to many people, and many workforce who have been suffering from professional issues. Thank you very much. Thank you for listening.
Thank you, Amika. Sir, if you have a question.
Yes, Isha, why would you like to have this set up as an NGO?
Sir, because my main focus has always been to improve the human capital of the nation. I have never been focusing on improving the working capital or something like that. I want to be the kind of entrepreneur who works to improve the human capital of the nation. That is why I'll be dealing it as a NGO.
But even human capital can be, you know, raised by making profit. That you said in the last slide also, that you'd be aiming to have profit, right?
Yeah, sir. Yeah, so through the contributions that I'll be getting or the donations, you can say, being it an NPO, I'll be approaching the government with my plan. And in case they find it suitable, they'll be providing me with the funding and various other organizations.
Okay, to whom in the government you'd be approaching for the fund?
Sir, initially, I'll be going to the state government, being at the initial level, and
which department of the government?
So the innovation sector, innovation council. I have researched about it. Actually, they have been providing, if they find the business plan to have, you know, that kind of power, that it will be able to help the nation.
Certainly, but your business plan must be, you know, viable financially, right? So government must see the merit in it. So my question is, which department in the government would you approach for funding?
The HRD, the Human Resource Department.
HRD is now no more, right?
Okay.
So you don't approach anyone, right?
I'll improve my knowledge, sir. Thank you for
again. My issue is with the part of finance here.
Okay, sir.
Right, and second issue is with the mentors.
Okay,
right, who would be your mentors? Most of the good organization, they have their own counseling team, right?
Okay.
So I don't know how you're going to approach them, because none of the slide and even in your plan, you have mentioned this one, how you're going to approach the corporates, right?
Okay. With
your idea that they must, you know, provide you the clients, right?
Yeah.
Because you're going to approach the corporate, right? And third issue is that because of the problem which you mentioned with the brain and all these things, right, I don't know how people are going to rely on your kind of app that you have not mentioned, right? So possibly good mentors may attract them, and good mentors would be costly, right, to find out, to have them in your team would be very difficult and expensive.
Okay,
right, so the cost must be realistic, right?
So even teachers like you and students like you can be the mentor for people working in the similar field.
They will not rely, right? Certainly, right?
Okay.
Because they want, see, you're looking at the human brains, and they will not like to take advice from teachers. Do you take always advice from teachers, everything, for everything?
Actually, the point is, I would like to explain that through the help of an example.
That is the issue. No? I know it, so therefore, no. It's not the teachers, because we may be expert in the subject in some area, but mentors, now you are looking at something different way, right? Different set of people.
The mentors will be from various professional backgrounds, not just limited to the teachers.
So that will add all your expenses. Your expense would go very high.
Sir, they will be doing it voluntarily. That is why they will be called as mentors.
Voluntarily?
Yeah,
sir. So you'll find if you approach out of 100, you'll find hardly 5 to 10 people. That is a realistic figure, right? So
yeah,
all
sir.
The best, maybe you need to explore all these things. See, whenever you are submitting a plan to everybody, to you and to the people earlier and later on, No, you question every all aspects, whether it is viable from every angle, not only financial angle.
Yes, sir.
Operational angle also, is it viable or not? See, budget finance is not a problem. Most of the good organizations which you hear, say Flipkart is still making losses, even though they are going for, no, they were acquired by huge funds and they are coming with the IPO. And same is with the other status also. So funding is not an issue unless you have a foolproof idea. So how do you get a foolproof idea? You find out each and everything aspects of it. Fine.
Okay.
Right.
Thank you for enhancing my knowledge. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Isha. The next up is Mehak.
Well,
yeah, you're audible.
Is it visible?
Yep, it is.
How easy or difficult is to find a job in our country? Why is it so difficult for young people to find a job? Have you ever had problem finding a job? Good morning, my name is Mehak. I am studying in Kalandi College. Today I am here to share my business plan with all of you. Before starting, I would like to discuss some points about presentation which will act as a roadmap. These points are our team, statement of purpose, the business, description of a business, our services, marketing, operational procedure, competition, financial data, capital, equipment and supply list, balance sheet and 5-year goals. About us, we will help to create jobs and reduce youth unemployment, provide skills to students needed for a job, solve problems of companies by getting skilled and trained employees, create new opportunities, help interns to get more better and competitive CVs. Our team consists of 4 members. First is our leader, who will execute business operation. A purpose behind a goal just filled. The second is sales professional. Young high-tech startups are at a constant risk of forgetting they need to sell the wonderful technology they invented. The third one is website developer, who will create our website and applicant tracking system to meet the resumes and interviews hiring. The fourth is operational superstar, who will develop high-stack development, funding and selling to keep the office network running, get processes documented, and to manage to keep everyone safe and busy. Statement of purpose, competitive service. It is a platform which is fastest career experience with kept youth in mind. It will make career simple, experience-oriented, personal and rewarding. With help of artificial intelligence and assistive technology, we can solve the issue of youth unemployment. Our business will be categorized into 4 parts. Number 1 is internship, 2 is traineeship. Traineeship are generally for those who want full-time jobs for graduates or recent graduates and required skills for job. Our 3rd one is entry-level job. These jobs are created for those who have experience of 2 to 3 years. Example, marketing executive and social media influencer. Our 4th one is part-time volunteer. Students will get experience how to address to events and participate in events. Example, students, college students can learn from real-life experience. What will be our operational position? And why is our platform different from other competitors? As it acts as a mediator between company and students and complete the gap and solves the problem. We have a mission to make career simple, professional, and rewarding. Competition. It can become global startup ecosystem. It will top corporates, government, and startup programs to deliver company growth through investments, pilots, grants, partnership, and services. As to increase digital startup, this startup can become a mediator between companies and employees to solve a problem to get skilled and experienced employees, and employees get better job experience in less amount of time. What are our services? Our platform helps students and recent university graduates get the taste of work experience or land their full first-time job by connecting them with the great employers. User experience designer, focused on creating digital experiences, empower people and solve real-world problems. seeking long-term employment in an organization where they can grow professionally and further enhance their skills, knowledge, and experience. We will help to reduce market gap, to reduce jobs by students by combining education and technology, which is known as EduTech. What are our marketing platforms? Number one is posting on social media. Second, event sponsorships. Third is diversification. And fourth is email marketing. As students will help to get employment, skills can be taken students for marketing. Financial data. As our platform will provide free for students and charge from companies, which will post on our website and select better skills employees for their companies. Capital equipment and support. Government programs that offer the scholarship. Second is fundraising. Third is family. And third is personal loans. What is our five-year goal plan? We can add a virtual assistant that speed holds up for employers looking for talent and community, searching for jobs, as success is not a destination, it's a journey. Thank you.
5 minutes are over.
Ma'am, it's done.
Okay, thank you, Mehak. Sir, if you would like to ask a question.
Yes, Mehak, why you are focusing only on entry-level jobs?
Our business is categorized for all of the traineeship, also internship, also part-time volunteer also. The students who don't have experience get experience from this internships also.
And
which
are the other players in the market? Did you find out? The other companies?
Sir, I have found that Naukri.com is an application which is acts as a mediator.
That is a leader in it, but there are small kind of entity.
Yes, sir.
And what about the college placement cell? Would they be your competitor? Because most of college, they have their own placement cell for the internship and for initial jobs.
Yes, sir. But the CVs today now are selected by scanning and mapping. And they get scored. The importance of our internship get also from beginning only.
Your voice is cracking, Mac. I am not able to hear it. But anyhow, we need to find out, because you said your target audience are the trainees, the initial beginners. And I guess most of the good colleges, they have their own placement cell, would be your real competitor, right? And because they provide, they help in getting internship, they provide in the getting in initial jobs. So where do you fit in? So you need to seriously question it.
But sir, all students
are... They try, the students who are left, possibly there is a serious issue in them. But most of them are placed through the placement cell in most of the good colleges. You try to explore it. Anna? So they would be your serious competitor, and they do it without any cost, any charge. So you need to look at your financials also. Right? Say from the crowd of 100, say if 80 are placed, remaining 20 may not be, they would be right now having not such skill for the placement. And if you are trying to help them, it will be a costly affair. We need to look at these aspects. Fine, sir. All the best.
Sir, we will give. Sir, we will help to give them a better resume also.
Better?
Better resume for the future jobs also.
Only resume cannot give you a job. Right. Okay, right. So maybe you need to explore with your team. You said there will be four members. So you need to ask it, who would be your competitors, what they are doing, how do you be getting finances. Finances means your finances for sustain. Now, how do you sustain? Because you need to invest in office salaries for the employees and so on. Okay, right. So...
Okay,
look at these aspects. All the best. Next one, please.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Mehak. The next one is Ritu Singh. Ritu, can you please present your screen if you're there?
Yes, just a second.
हो गया लेकिन
there's some issue with Ritu Singh, then can give chance to the next one till she figures out what's the problem.
Okay, ma'am. So,
are you able to share your screen, Peter? Ritu, can you hear us?
Yes, ma'am.
So, are you able to share your screen or not?
No, ma'am. Right now, no.
Okay, so just try to figure out. Let us give the chance to the next one.
Huh? Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. So I'll go on to the next one. The next one is Sai Smaran.
Yes, so let me share my screen. One minute. Is it visible?
Yes, it's visible.
Thank you. So my name is Sai Smaran, studying class 11th of Deeksha PU College, Bangalore. So I have built an IoT mask and I'm a TEDx speaker as well. So what is a mask and why do we need to wear a mask? Mask is an object worn on the face for protection. Masks are barriers that help to prevent the respiratory droplets from reaching others. Wearing a face mask will help to prevent the spread of infectious germs. When someone coughs or sneezes, they could release germs into the air that may infect others. These masks will help to prevent these germs. What is an IoT? IoT means Internet of Things. Internet of Things is referred to as internet connected to various objects and are able to collect transfer data over a wireless technology without any human interface. What is Bluetooth? Bluetooth is a wireless technology used for exchange data between fixed mobile device over a short distance. The main drawback for Bluetooth is that it could be used on a short distance, whereas IoT can be used at a longer range. What is an IoT mask? The pics of my IoT mask is towards the left. You could just view it. So the main motive is to create this type of mask is that the normal mask or the surgical mask which we wear, we get a fog thing on our spectacles, which leads to many problems while driving or walking on streets. To avoid that, I have built this mask. And there's a centrifugal fan which helps in removing the hot air. And to control the fan speed, I have developed an application. My mask is IoT enabled, that is Internet of Things. It could be connected to my Wi-Fi or we can use our own internet hotspot as well. If in case if there's any network issue or any signal problem, it could be switched into an offline mode. My mask is in the prototype stage. I'm currently working on this to make a product. What is a Bluetooth mask? It does the same thing what the IoT mask does, but as compared to IoT mask, Bluetooth masks are low cost so that the people could buy at an affordable rate. I've totally done two prototypes and now I'm working on a product and embedded system so that I could make my mask in a more smaller and compact way. App for controlling IoT mask, I'll be using a Blink app. And for controlling the Bluetooth mask, with the help of MIT app inventor, I've built an app and I'll be adding features related to voice commands, etc. And I'll be introducing a new feature that is notification, which helps in notifying to wear a mask at a particular point of time. And to control the mask in offline mode, I'll use a touch sensor instead of a manual switch. So I have been featured on various platforms. I have met Bangalore MP and TechWiki. It's an Egypt software company. And I have won competition, which was conducted by VIT Bhopal and Amity University, Mumbai. Thank you.
Thank you, Saisman. So if you would like to ask a question.
Okay, Sai, interesting product which you are developing. How much does the prototype cost?
So the IoT mask cost around 600 to 700. As it's too costlier, I have developed an alternative. It just cost around 200 to 300, the Bluetooth mask.
And it'll have all the features of any good mask, right?
Yes, sir. And even SpaceX is building such type of mask. And there's recently a mask which was developed and it is present in Dubai, but it's not available in India.
Okay, because recently someone has shared me a mask built by LG.
Yeah, LG, yes, sir.
It's
around 21,000.
Yes.
Yeah, but it's not. It's too costly.
But compared to that, you are saying your cost prototype is 600 to 700 rupees.
Yeah.
Okay, and how much would be the weight of the mask?
So the weight is too heavy. I have not yet judged it. But this is a 3D printed model in which I'll be adding all my microcontrollers, and the relays, and I'll be sticking into an N95 mask like this, and it includes a fan here, and it could be portable one. It could be removed anytime and sticked anytime, and this mask could be washable anytime, or else you could use an alternative mask again. You could buy a new one.
When you're attaching all these things, Bluetooth and this IoT kind of thing, so I think, can you wash it?
Yeah, this detachable. Okay. Yeah.
So that can fit into the mask again after the use, right?
Yeah, yes.
Okay, so only issue is, one is the cost, because I have now in my mind that cost is 27,000 rupees by LG. Yeah. You are saying 600 rupees.
Yeah.
So certainly if you come up with this kind of mask, it will be a hit. Second thing is that the weight, mostly people who are wearing masks, they find it very difficult to keep it for a long period of time.
Yes, sir, that's true.
Right, so these two issues must be addressed properly.
Yeah, the normal mask is around 5 grams, but this mask made me around 30 grams, which is too heavy. So I'm working on the weight part also. I'm increasing my time on this product and giving more time to make such type of 3D printing modules, and then I'm trying out. It's in the R&D process still.
So you're getting help from someone else also in this?
No, sir.
That's good. You are in class 11, man. You're continuing with your study also.
Yes, sir.
That's good. All the best.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Sai. The next one up is Samarth Sundaram. Samarth, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear. Thank you. Namaskar. So my topic is track accident prevention using data science. I'm from Ram Lakhan Singh Yadav College. Before I start, I would first like to share the problems which causes the accident. So there are 7 points which I have mentioned that causes accidents in railway tracks, like human error, problem with the tracks, distracted pedestrians, and terrorism, unprotected crossings, suicides, animal crossings. So these are some events which happened, tragedies in railway track. In Amritsar 10 disaster in October 19, 2018, and other one where a guy was keeping the LPG cylinder in the railway track to make videos and earn money. So the solution is by mounting a camera on the top of the engine, and we will collect the data, and we will train the model to track down what is the track and what is not track, and then we will train it, and we will look for the objects in the track. If there is an object, we will alert the locomotive engine that there is an object. So this is a brief description of the solution. And the software we're working on is by using machine learning, in using Python as a language to approach the problem. So what we will do is we cannot go on the railway track to collect the data. So my way is doing is to first collect the data in a toy train by using a webcam or a small camera and collect the data and then train the data. And then after collecting the data, we have to train the data in different models, and whichever accuracy is more better, we will put that as a software in the camera, and then we will test it. If it's unable, like if it is able to predict the threat in front of the train, and the gives the output accuracy is like above 90 or 80%, then it will work. And the other model is by collecting the data of the railway tracks. That means collecting the sound of the railway track, where we will collect the sound, like how the sound wave works when the track is not detached. And then we will check the data, like how it will work when there is no railway track, means if the track is detached, and what is the difference in that. We will then share it, like we will alert, like these waves are not the how it should usually be, and then we will alert the engineer that there is a threat in the railway track. So that's all. Yes. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Samarth. Sir, if you have a question for him.
Samarth, what is the system right now is used by the railways, apart from manual handling of these issues? Because there are many, what is the current kind of system which the Indian Railway uses? Except the places where it is a manual, there are many places where these automatic things have been done. So what kind of system they are using? Did you study those?
Yes, I have studied data science. So in that, what we collect the data and we train the data. And after training the data, we check for accuracy in the models.
That is fine. Data science application is okay. My question is, there are many news where we hear that the railways, they are trying to modernize the track system as well as the crossings.
Yes.
So the places where it has been done, modernized, what kind of system it is being used? Did you study those?
No, I haven't studied about those.
Because we need to find out whether your prototype or the application which you're proposing compared to the existing system which Indian Railway is using, right? Is it better than that? The first step, right? Because you have nowhere mentioned in your presentation as well as your business plan, right? Then only you can go ahead with it, possibly.
Okay.
Right. So first step is, my suggestion is to study the existing system and then try to find out how we can improve it. Right, okay. Or improvement can be done on the basis of operationally, let's say you are using data science, or maybe through the cost. So you can use the same thing at a lower cost, provide railway the same usage machine at a lower cost. Then only it will be feasible, right? So first step is that you study the existing one. This is the suggestion I've given to everybody. And in none of the business plan, people have studied the existing model. That is important. Only from there you try to find out what would be the better one. Okay. Otherwise, how would you find better?
Yes, sir.
You have existing system, you find that is not so good. How would you build a better system?
Yes.
Right. So try to find existing railway, what they are using, because it's so vast, right? After so many years, they have not done everything automatically. Right. It's still manual at more than 50% of the location. Right. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Samarth. The next up is Danish.
हाय सर हेलो
हाँ दानिश आप मुझे सुन सकते हैं
जी जी बिल्कुल सर
हाँ ठीक है तो अब आप अपना प्रेजेंट करो
या सर माय नेम इज दानिश जिशान सो आई फ्रॉम इन बिहार
दानिश बेटा आपका स्क्रीन शेयर नहीं हो रहा डू यू हैव एनी प्रेजेंटेशन
ओके ओके वन सेकंड तो नेटवर्क प्रॉब्लम है
इफ यू यू डू नॉट हैव अ प्रेजेंटेशन यू कैन जस्ट स्पीक हाउ वुड यू लाइक टू गिव द प्रेजेंटेशन
प्रेजेंटेशन इज नॉट अवेलेबल
ओह दैट्स ओके यू वांट टू जस्ट स्पीक
या
आपको बोलना ही है बच्चे बस मतलब बोल के समझाएंगे अपना मॉडल ओके
जी जी
No problem.
हिंदी में बोल सकता हूँ मैं
हाँ बिल्कुल बिल्कुल I'm sure सर को सर is it okay if he speaks in Hindi
जी जी बिल्कुल
हाँ जी बोलिए दानिश No problem
दानिश सर मैंने
दानिश की सॉल्यूशन है आप डायरेक्टली जो है प्रॉब्लम को बहुत ही ब्रीफ में बताएं और क्या सॉल्यूशन है उसका क्योंकि
जी.
आपके बिजनेस प्लान में 3-4 पेजेस में देरी पार्ट लिखा है
आजकल बढ़ चुका है सो इसलिए इसके बारे में मतलब कहें तो बहुत सारे लोग इससे एक साल के अंदर मतलब 90% लोग इससे मौत हो जाती जितना कोविड से नहीं होती इतना एयर पॉल्यूशन से हो जाती है तो इससे हेलो सुन पा रहे हैं सर हेलो
यस यस गो हां
यस यस ओके वायु प्रदूषण में खतरा बहुत होता है सर इसमें वायु प्रदूषण जो होता है बहुत खतरा होता है इसमें तो एक वर्ष में 300 से अधिक समय होते हैं तो इसमें काफी मौतें हो जाती हैं तो इससे जैसे ग्रामीणों में उतने पॉल्यूशन नहीं होते हैं शहरों में ज्यादा होते हैं तो मेरा ये कहना है कि एयर पोल्यूशन के लिए कम से कम लोगों को कार चलानी चाहिए कंपनी को थोड़ा वो एयर पोल्यूशन के बारे में चेक करना चाहिए थोड़ा कारों को तो कंपनी ओनली कंपनी के बारे में कंपनी को सोचना चाहिए थोड़ा लोगों के बारे में तो मैं कहूँगा कि मास्क इज अ बेटर बहुत अच्छा रहेगा मास्क लगाने से तो कुछ कम होगा उससे मास्क लगाने से जैसे COVID-19 चला है तो इससे भी थोड़ा खतरा बहुत लोगों को खतरा हुआ है तो बहुत ज्यादा हुआ है तो एयर पोल्यूशन से भी ज्यादा तो हेलो हेलो
दानिश आपका सोल्यूशन क्या है प्रॉब्लम का आप उस पे फोकस कीजिए बेटा और जल्दी टाइम सिर्फ 5 मिनट है आपके पास
जी जी बिल्कुल बिल्कुल इसका सोल्यूशन है कि मास्क लगाना जरूरी होता है बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है मास्क तो इसलिए इसको कम करने के लिए जांच केंद्र खोलना चाहिए एक और जांच केंद्र खोलना तो चाहिए तो चेक करना चाहिए सरकार जो होती है वो भी चेक करती है वो भी जांच केंद्र खुलवा चुकी है तो इसलिए मैं चाहता हूँ कंपनी खोलना है जैसे मतलब एग्जाम्पल तो कंपनी खोलना चाहता हूँ उसमें चाहता हूँ मैं कि एक लेबर हो मतलब जांच केंद्र होना चाहिए उसमें भी जांच केंद्र खोलूं मैं तो उसमें हर एक गाड़ी को हर एक पार्ट मतलब जो पॉल्यूशन से मतलब भरी होती है गाड़ी तो उसको चेक करके अच्छे से उसको चेक करना चाहिए अच्छा तो इसलिए मैं यही सोचता हूँ कि मास्क इज अ बेटर पर्सन ओके सर
ओके
दानिश हम लोग क्लियर नहीं हो पाए कि आप क्या करना चाहेंगे मास्क लगाएंगे किस में गाड़ी में
नहीं नहीं मास्क लोगों को लगाने चाहिए जो बाहर टहलते हैं ऐसे घूमते हैं
और जैसे काम हुआ गाड़ी के हर पार्ट्स को
नहीं एयर पोल्यूशन जहां से निकलता है जांच केंद्र में जाके वो एयर पोल्यूशन को चेक करेंगे ना कि पार्ट्स को चेक करेंगे जो कस्टमर्स रहेंगे तो स्टाफ चेक करेंगे उनको कंपनी वाले स्टाफ जितने होते हैं कंपनी में जाती है गाड़ियां तो उसको चेक की जाती है
आप क्या करना चाहेंगे
मैं हर एक स्टाफ को बोलूं मतलब हर एक स्टाफ रखूंगा मैं और बोलूंगा कि इसको मतलब क्लियरली चेक करो ताकि इसमें कोई मतलब दिक्कत मतलब किसी को लोगों को दिक्कत ना हो इससे आजकल बहुत मौत है इससे।
दानिश ये तो मुझे नहीं लग रहा कि कोई बिजनेस प्लान वगैरह है ये है ना, तो उसको थोड़ा वर्कआउट करिए आपकी जो भी आप इशू बता रहे हैं उसका क्या उपाय है उसको ढूंढिए आप है ना, ये कुछ बिजनेस प्लान नहीं लग रहा है ठीक है।
थोड़ा
देखो कि बिजनेस प्लान वगैरह कैसे बनते हैं है ना, कैसे बनाए जाते हैं बिजनेस प्लान। मे बी आप शुरू से हैं, लॉग इन किया हुआ है आपने शुरू से?
जी जी।
तो इससे पहले जो भी प्रेजेंटर थे उनका भी आप ने सुना होगा क्या बनाया उन्होंने, कैसे किया, कैसे सॉल्यूशन फाइंड करने की बात कर रहे हैं।
जी जी।
फिर जब आइडिया अच्छा आएगा तो मे बी श्योरली नेक्स्ट जो IIC का होगा कॉम्पिटिशन तो उसमें आप भाग लीजिए। हैं
ओके सर, थैंक यू सर।
थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू दानिश। द नेक्स्ट अप इज रितु सिंह।
यस
रितु, हैव यू फिक्स्ड योर प्रॉब्लम, कैन यू प्रेजेंट?
Rahul, maybe you can help Ritu. Can you present her?
Yeah, ma'am, I will present her on her.
Yeah, and she can speak.
Yeah,
she has her PPT, na? Ritu. Don't worry, sir will present your PPT and you can speak.
One more thing, Monica ma'am.
Yes ma'am, yes sir.
अगर कुछ PPT में कुछ different है, new है, तब present करने की ज़रूरत है, otherwise plan तो है ही हमारे पास।
जी जी जी।
Already हो रहा है, इनका presentation हो रहा है, ठीक है।
जी हाँ, sir हो रहा है। रितु, आप बोल सकते हो? आपकी आवाज़ आ रही है हमारी आपके पास? I think there's some issue in her internet.
Yes, ma'am. She has some network issues.
She has some issue. So, ठीक है, we have her plan. हमारे पास इनकी PPT भी है, इनका abstract भी है. तो sir उसको judge कर लेंगे. She cannot participate here. Is there any other participant? Unnavu?
Yes, ma'am. There is one last one, Deeksha Porwal. Like, and I don't think she's.
Ritu Singh is muted. Gaurav, please unmute her. Okay. Ritu, now can you speak?
Is the PPT visible, ma'am?
Yeah, PPT is visible.
Okay.
Ritu, can you speak? Unko co-host banaiye bhai. Gaurav hai?
Yes, ma'am. I am calling.
Yes, ma'am.
Gaurav.
Gaurav, उसको co-host बनाओ.
किनको मैम?
रितु सिंह को.
जी मैम, बनाया था मैम, पता नहीं हट गए होंगे. Yes, done, ma'am.
रितु, now you can unmute.
Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible. Please go ahead and just. You just have 5 minutes to be precise, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Ritu Singh and my startup name is Khana Khazana. So before getting into the idea part, let's start with the problems of hostels and PG students which we are facing nowadays. The first thing that makes you want to realize that you are no longer at home is the food. And then there comes a time when you have had so much of pasta, pizza, noodles for all your meals, that even the thought of them makes you want to puke. While the hostel fees and PG rents are skyrocketing, the mess food still remains same, the old, bland, tasteless food. Sometimes students who live in hostels and PG couldn't survive a year and returns because of their badly going down health. The food is never of your choice, since there is a fixed menu for everyone. The hygiene or quality of food is not good. They will use the cheapest of oil to make all your food. The food they make can rarely be called food. It is usually tasteless and nutrition deficient. I think the food is the most difficult aspect of the hostel or PG life. Now let's talk about the problems of housewives in India. Generally, housewives have to be dependent on others. Since 2001, more than 20,000 housewives have killed themselves every year in India. They sometimes don't find themselves worth it. Indian housewives are amongst the most overqualified demographic groups in the world. Instead of that, they work 24 hours a day, but they don't get any recognition regarding their work. Many families doesn't support their daughter-in-law to work outside. Women should take their own stand if they want to grow and to become independent. Now here comes the idea part. The Khana Khajana app brings happiness to both the hostler of PG students and housewife, as it helps both of them to fulfill their required needs and wants. What hostlers of PG students really wants? A good, healthy, and tasteful meal. What a housewife wants? To become economically independent. That's what this idea would give to both of them. What idea is all about? Any hostler or PG students who don't want to eat food off their mess, then they can simply give order of the food which they want to eat. After that, nearby housewives who have registered to the app would make their food. And our Khana Khajana delivery boy or girl would simply deliver the food to the students. Housewife names will begin to show in the app as soon as you open it and select your delivery place. You just have to select any nearby housewife name, and under this category, you have to write the meal which you want to eat and select mode of payment. Now, here comes the short analysis of this business model. What its strength? The population of students, hygienic food, the gharwali feeling in every meal, simple meal that is roti, dal, sabji, that's what students crave for. In North India, it will make a great profit. What its weakness? It needs funding. Establishing trust takes time to assure the housewife that it is beneficial for them. It dependent on hostlers or PG students and internet. It needs resources. What its opportunities? Employment level increases. It can expand to other states also. Increasing independence leads to economic stability. Prices will low so that it will grab attention of the customers. Only app which gives you the normal healthy meal. What its threats? There will be intense competition in the market, the weather problem, changes in government policies, advanced technology required. The business model can be imitated by the others. Moving on to the next topic, commercial viability. How it's going to grow in the market, how it's going to compete their competitors. No hostlers or PG students want to eat junk food daily. At the end, they only want a simple, tasteful, hygienic, and a healthy meal. Only a plate of roti, dal, and sabji can fill their stomach. That's what Khana Khajana would give to their students. Other competitors like Zomato, Swiggy offers restaurant foods, which are generally not hygienic, and they charge a high price for every meal. And you have to order from the restaurant menu. But this app gives you the opportunity to give orders whatever you want to eat. Yes, there are many different services also available in the market. And no doubt their taste is slightly better than the mess food. But the issue with them is that they have a fixed routine of a meal every day. This business has the ability to grow in the market and to make profit.
Sorry to interrupt. Your time has got over.
Okay, ma'am, just give me a few seconds. A student needs a healthy meal and housewife needs a place where they can sell their food. They both need each other. So this business idea would definitely survive in the market. Although it's a long-term business model because students obviously go outside to study. So there will always be a buyer waiting to buy and there will always be any housewife willing to work. So there will always be a seller outside to sell. Hence, this business enterprises would definitely sustain in the market and be commercially viable. That's the end of my presentation. Thank you for your kind attention.
Ritu, sir, if you have a question for her.
Ritu, how do you ensure the quality aspect of your business?
Sir, in comparison to the restaurant food, the quality aspect of the food which we are making in the kitchen, in the house, is slightly better than that.
How do you ensure it? Only sir, by saying it?
No, sir, we can arrange a few, we can employ a few men.
Did you explore how quality can be ensured in the market, in a food business? Have you heard about something called as FSSAI?
Yes, sir. Food Corporation of India.
Not Food Corporation of India. Check it, FSSAI, right? And second aspect is, how would you know supply from kitchen to the end user? Did you find it?
Sir, there will be a delivery boy or something like that, because in Zomato, there...
Something like that may not work. No, you need to specify it. Now, this would be your model. Because all these would involve finance as well as the other technical issues, right? And did you find any other company in this area, in your business, kind of business? You talked about Zomato and Swiggy, and I'm surprised you have not put that in SWOT analysis, because they are the real threat of your business. Are you aware Swiggy and Zomato?
Sir, I'm not getting your voice.
Professor Singh, please check the connection. I think there's some problem. So can you hear us? Professor Singh, audible to all of you?
No, ma'am. I think there's some network issue on his side.
No, ma'am. No. Actually, his screen has frozen, I believe.
Maybe.
Connectivity.
You can join again. No problem. Anyway, Unnavo, is there any more participants?
Ma'am, Deeksha Pohwal is there, lekin I don't think she's...
She's not joined now?
Yes. No, ma'am. I don't think so.
So, how many presentations did we have today?
Ma'am...
Ma'am, it's eight presentations.
This Vedant is raising hand. He wants to discuss some idea. We'll take the permission of Professor Singh and see if he allows, and then we can wrap up.
So now after.
Sir has joined.
I was disconnected.
Now you're audible, sir. Yes, your screen was frozen for some time.
No, my data went off.
Okay.
So to Ritu, one more suggestion I was giving, and this is to all, because many of them have not studied the existing businesses in their area, right? So Swiggy and Zomato both are doing the same kind of business. If I want to supply food from a house, I can get FSSAI license, GST number, and then I can sell it on Swiggy and Zomato. This is what she is also referring to, right? So this is a suggestion, because when you're proposing a business plan, you need to find out who would be your real competitor. Unless there is no gap between existing supplier and you in a business, how would you justify your fitness in it? That is a suggestion to everybody. Okay, ma'am, you were saying about a new participant, no? This is your choice.
Vedant had not submitted his idea, but he wants to present his idea now, if you allow.
Okay,
Vedant. Inko co-host banaiye bhai, Gaurav. Vedant, are you there?
Shivam is not here. Shanti Kumar is not here. Pooja is also not here, right?
Yeah, they and have Diksha joined. I just wanted to discuss. Initially, we had planned for 5 prizes, but since the participants are less, you can go for 3 prizes, first, second, and third.
Right, right. Take care.
Vedant, would you like to present? Just make him the co-host, Gaurav. Isko unmute karo bhai. Gaurav?
हाँ मैम कर रहे हैं वो आई जस्ट स्पोक
ठीक है हाँ इसको अनम्यूट करो
या डन मैम
वेदांत वेदांत यू कैन अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ एंड जस्ट प्रेजेंट योर आइडिया एंड बी वेरी प्रिसाइज प्लीज वी आर ऑलरेडी शॉर्ट ऑफ टाइम
मैम एम आई ऑडिबल
या यू आर ऑडिबल जस्ट गो
थैंक यू एवरीवन फॉर लेटिंग मी स्पीक सो आइडिया इज वेरी सिंपल We have seen a sudden declination in the purchase of electric vehicles in past few years. And now the world is shifting towards electric vehicles and electric vehicles is the future. So the plan is very simple. We'll buy some electric vehicles like electric scooters, electric bikes, or maybe cars and give them on rent for a month, a 3 month, 6 months, or even a year. This might help students who are living away from their houses. It can help people who are working away from their houses. So the traveling cost in a city like Delhi would go up to 2000 to 2500 rupees if a person is even using metro or auto rickshaws. So but when they'll take our scooters on rent, it will cost them around 1500 to 2000 rupees. And as they are electric vehicle, it would not cost them even for fuel prices. So this was the idea.
Vedant, this idea came right now or you were planning earlier?
So I was planning it earlier.
No, but it didn't seem that you were planning earlier. Jaise nahi aata, suddenly kuch idea aya, then you said something in the...
No, sir, I was planning to work on it, but I have no... I don't have a team or something like that.
Okay right. So you talked about fuel cost, but do you know the cost of electric vehicle right now in India?
So yes, electric scooter. Hero is making electric
scooter.
So no, the price of electric scooter is high. So the electric scooter price is around 45,000 to 50,000.
The Chinese scooter, right?
No, the Hero one.
Most of them.
So the Hero India has made an electric scooter. Hello.
I think there is a connection problem with
you are aware of this fact, right?
Yeah.
It is not successful. So maybe you can look at the cost. Saying this one is much easy. Even a big company like Maruti, who are having the subscription-based kind of thing, which you are suggesting, they are not successful in this model. They are just delivering this kind of service to hand-numbered cities in India. So maybe you look at the financial, right? And suddenly the idea may be good if you make it more interesting, because in future, people are moving away from owned vehicle to the subscription vehicle, right? Especially in a city like, say, Bangalore, Mumbai, and Delhi. Fine. So work on the financial aspect and work on what the existing how you can make it more attractive, right? Okay, ma'am. This was the last one.
Yes, sir. I think that's all. Unnavo?
Yes, ma'am. That's all.
Okay. Sir, would you like to give the results just now or would you like to take time? So let us decide for 3 prizes then, because the number of participants were less.
Do you want me to tell right now or we can tell them later?
Any which way you want. It's okay with us.
I think it's better would be that you can communicate them later on.
Okay, fine. No problem.
Because I need to discuss a few more things before we do this one.
Sure, sir. So this is, we are going to announce the results. later on, and you will be informed on email. Dr. Neha will be in touch with all the participants, and the winners will be the account details of the winners will be taken by Dr. Neha. Okay, so let us go for formal vote of thanks from Unnavo. So this brings to the end of the competition.
Please give me 2 minutes before we wind up, right?
Yeah, sure, sir. Please.
Right. Even though we announce the result, doesn't matter much. Because some ideas are good, some ideas are not so good, but none of the idea was bad, right? At the UG level, it's very good, right? The effort taken by everybody here, right? And the backup, you, ma'am, and the college. But there are few suggestions, I'd like to say, because this was the regular event in my college when I was in BIT Mesrae Noida campus, right? So this was a regular event for BBA and MBA.
Yeah.
Right. And also we invited this Seema, the UK, come to our college to have this. So my suggestion is to everybody that whenever you're planning it, the existing business, none of them have done it. And everybody is thinking that you are the only one. Right. That is a problem. When we go to buy a mobile phone, we said, compare, contrast and find out which is best. Same thing when somebody would like to put money in your business, so you need to make effort. So that part of effort was lacking in all the plans. So
valuable advisors will enhance their ideas, I'm sure, later on, because they are going to get various chances in various competitions.
And second important aspect is that when you are saying that, okay, you'd be selling it, you'd be manufacturing it, you'd be offering service to the market, then we need to find actually, is there any gap between demand and supply or not? The basic economics works like this one, that there is a gap between, we don't have existing suppliers, sellers in the market to fulfill the demand. And sometimes demand may not be there in the market. We need to create demand. Right, we need to create demand by offering, okay, this is what we are offering and people would like to buy it. So gap must be studied properly. And then only you can justify that because of this gap, we are going to provide this kind of solution to the problem. So for example, the railway guy, student who was offering the railway kind of machine learning platform, I asked him, what is the existing kind of technology railway is using? And without knowing that the existing technology, how can you say, okay, we'll be offering to railway, right? Same is with the other one also, like say food business for Ritu. Swiggy and Zomato, they are already offering this one. So how you can claim that you are a new kind of business in the market? They are a big pocket, deep pocket business. So you need to justify with your idea that you are slightly different than the rest, right? Then only that business can be viable, sustainable, in a market. Finance is not an issue. Good business would get good finance. Thank you so much, ma'am, for giving
me. Thank you so much. Thank you for your time, your valuable time. You gave 2 hours and you gave such valuable advices to the participants and the students. I'm sure they're going to enhance their ideas now.
Surely.
Okay, Unnavo, we can go for formal vote of thanks.
It's an honor to have been asked to offer the word of thanks on the occasion of the final round of the National Level Business Plan / Prototype Competition in our college. On behalf of Shyamlal College and the Innovation Council, I'm grateful to all the conveners for sharing their thought-provoking words with us. My gratitude goes out to our honorable chief guest, Dr. K.B. Singh, for his valuable time and inputs on the various presentations given by the participants. I'm thankful to all the participants for coming here and sharing their innovative ideas with us. I take this opportunity to thank our teachers, students, and sponsors who were involved in the smooth conduct of this event. It would not have been possible to make this event happen without the guidance and constant support of our principal, Professor Ravi Narayankar. I would like to extend our sincere gratitude to him. And thank you everyone for being such a great audience. Cue the applause. Kriti.
Thank you.
Thank you, Kriti. Thank you, Unnavo.
Thank you so much.
Special thanks and vote of thanks to Unnavo for handling the entire session. There has been a little rescheduling about the presentations. And to our surprise, we have received applications starting from 10th standard till PhD candidates. So there has been a huge amount of diversification amongst our participants. And the numbers are huge. The ideas are really very strategically different from each other. However, for every phase, for every startup idea is always in the phase of evolving. Even Paytm, Ola, Swiggy, Uber, Netflix, all of them are today evolving. Okay, so all those participants who have been receiving these comments from our expert that how they can polish their idea, that is really important for you to mark their words. And certainly these things always emerge and they are ever emerging. Okay, so with this entire session filled with encouragement from our expert, Singh sir, Principal sir, Monica ma'am, Bharat sir, Kusha ma'am, everybody, a huge round of applause for all of you and a great thanks to make this session a national level event and a success one. Thank you so much, all of you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you for your time. Thank you. Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you,
sir. So I'm leaving now, right?
Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am. And thank you, Neha ma'am, also.
Right. Thank you, sir.
I'll get in touch with you for the results.
Yeah, surely. I'll send you maybe in 10 minutes.
Yeah,
send you through WhatsApp, right?
Okay. Neha will get in touch with the participants. Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Yes. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am.
Namaskar.
Okay. Namaskar.
Neha ma'am?
Haan.
Meeting is over, ma'am. Kare?
Haan, meeting over.